Okay. The Wentworth Town Council meeting for October the 6th, 2020 is now called to order. We'll ask Councilman Pascal to do the invocation, please.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day and for all the many blessings that we have. Dear Lord, we thank you that we live in a free democracy where we can be together and talk about important issues that face our citizens. Dear Lord, we pray that you would be with us as we take up the business of the town tonight. And dear Heavenly Father, we ask that you would be with us as our nation continues to go through this pandemic and lead and guide us as we make important decisions related to that. It's in your name we pray. Amen.
Next is the approval of the town council agenda. Yvonne, did we have any requests or petitions from anybody?
No, we don't. No.
Okay. Next is the approval of the agenda. Does anybody have anything to add? If not, I'd like to make a motion that we approve the agenda as written.
I second it.
Have a motion and a second. Yvonne, will you do a roll call vote?
Yes, please state your vote, aye or nay. Cheryl Moore?
Aye.
Iris Powell?
Aye.
Evelyn Connor?
Aye.
Dennis Pascoe III?
Aye.
All voted in favor.
Okay. Next is the approval of the minutes. Anybody have any corrections or to the minutes? If not, I'd like to make a motion that the minutes stand approved as written.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Yvonne, would you do a roll call vote?
Please state your vote, aye or nay. Cheryl Moore?
Aye.
Iris Powell?
Aye.
Evelyn Connor?
Aye.
Dennis Pascoe?
Aye.
All voted in favor.
Okay. Next is old business. Consideration of a quote for privacy fencing between the park and the rental house. George, do you have any quotes or bids on that?
Requested it and have yet to receive it. And what's happened is that we got the original quotes in March of this year, and they are no longer valid, and so we're still waiting on them from Garcia Fencing. So at this point in time, I do not have an updated quotes for the fencing.
Okay, so we will need to table that for the November the, what date is that? November the 3rd meeting?
Did you say the 3rd?
Yes.
Are we still meeting on the 3rd? I couldn't remember. Did we move it because of Election Day, or are we still going to meet on the 3rd?
If it's a town council Election Day, we have it on the Thursday after Election Day.
Okay. Okay. Yes. Okay. That makes sense. Yep.
Okay. I'd like to make a motion that we table the quote for the fencing between the park and the rental house. Until the November meeting. I'm sorry.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Yvonne, can we do will you do a roll call vote?
Yes, please state your vote by saying aye or nay. Cheryl Moore?
Aye.
Iris Powell?
Aye.
Evelyn Connor?
Aye.
Dennis Pascoe?
Aye.
All voted in favor.
Okay, next is the consideration of a quote for privacy fencing around the dumpster pad. George, do you have any information on that?
I asked for the new quote. I also informed them that we had the dumpster pad there, and so I'm still awaiting information from them on that as well.
Okay, I'd like to make a motion that we table the quote on the privacy fencing around the dumpster pad until the November the 3rd meeting.
I second it.
I'll let Iris have that one.
Have a motion and a second. Yvonne, would you do a roll call vote?
Okay. Please say your vote, aye or nay. Cheryl Moore?
Aye.
Iris Powell?
Aye.
Evelyn Connor?
Aye.
Dennis Pascal?
Aye.
All voted in favor.
Okay. Next, under new business, consideration of amendment to fee schedule for Fox Rothschild LLP. Fox Rothschild has not increased the town's retainer fees since 2012. They are now requesting to increase the retainer fee from $1,100 to $1,500 and to keep the associate hourly rate to $280 an hour and partner rates at $325 an hour for non-retainer matters such as real estate closing. And I'd like to make a motion that we approve this increase.
Second.
Is it too much?
Well, they haven't increased since 2012, and it's only $400.
I'll approve it.
Is that a second, Iris?
Did somebody else make a motion?
Yeah, I think Dennis already seconded.
Okay. I heard him, but I wanted to make sure.
Okay.
Vaughn, would you do a roll call vote?
Yes, please state your vote, aye or nay. Cheryl Moore?
Aye.
Iris Powell?
Aye.
Evelyn Connor?
Aye.
Dennis Pascal?
Aye.
All voted in favor.
Next is the discussion of regulations for the Wentworth Park and the completion date.
Okay.
George.
Yes. At present, the expected completion date now is expected to be October 23rd. We know that originally we targeted for the end of August. We know that at some crucial times when grading was taking place, we had rain and you can't grade mud. And also that COVID-19 has come into effect. The playground equipment, for instance, was delivered, tomorrow will be 2 weeks ago. And they began the installation process on the playground, and that's moving along nicely. But one of the other major areas that difficulties come in is with the electrical work. I believe that the electrician subcontractor is using double D supplies for that. And that company has experienced some plant closings due to COVID. And so there's been a lot of difficulty in getting a lot of the electrical fixtures. That said, they are final thing, the shipment on those is supposed to be shipped on the 8th, which would be Thursday of this week, which means it should arrive next week. And there's a lot of things that are getting close to being wrapped up, like the drywall has been installed in the restrooms and they started working on the painting of the interior. They already have the fixtures, but they've got to get this done before they install them. But it's moving along nicely, and it looks like it will be, hopefully, knock on wood, the 23rd. So, any questions about with the park? All right, with procedures, I have looked at one of the other parks that Alan William Carman and King was the architect for was in Walkertown. And I've kind of used that as a guideline for maybe what we want to include and not include as far as activities in the park. The sheriff's office has stated, Sam Page has stated, that the deputies will be glad to have a key to the gates and to open the park at dawn and close the park at dusk. And of course, we'll monitor it throughout the day and everything with that. That will help as far as managing it. But I figure dusk to dawn operation is pretty much what you wanted with it at this point. What kind of activities do you want to allow? What kind of activities do you want to restrict? For instance, vendors inside the park, unless they're authorized by somebody with the town, do you want to avoid having vendors in the park?
I'm fine with vendors. I just think we would need to check and make sure that there aren't any issues with connectivity, depending on, you know, what kind of vendor it is, what they're going to have. You know, somebody was having a birthday party and, you know, they wanted to have a vendor bring inflatables. You know, I don't see anything wrong with that. I just think there probably needs to be some kind of rental form that they fill out when they initially want to rent that has that information on it, who they're going to rent, you know, if they're going to have an outside vendor or whatnot come in. And then if we have issues with vendors, then we can always tighten up on that. But I don't see any need to start, you know.
Just would allow vendors in right from the outset then.
Yep. What about through the health department with health permits, like food vendors? We need to cover that.
Well, when we did, it was probably about 2 years ago, we had that issue with food trucks and
right. It's
an ordinance that put things in place for food trucks. And I remember us having some discussion, although I can't remember it off the top of my head, about health department regulations. But I think they aren't necessarily governed, if it's a food truck, they're not necessarily governed by the Rockingham County Health Department, but they are governed at a state level. So to have that active permit, they would need to meet those requirements. So I would think as long as they had a permit to run a food truck, they should be good. Does anybody else remember that discussion?
You're right on that. I can double check, but I think it's a state level for food trucks. Only the counties have much to do with it.
Okay, that's what I was thinking. So we would just need to make sure if it was a food truck that they had all proper permits and things that they were supposed to have from the state.
That could be part of the application.
Yeah.
Okay.
All right, what about bicycles and tricycles?
No.
Looks like an accident getting ready to happen.
I mean, the only place you could really ride a bicycle is on the trail, and it's a quarter of a mile.
So, is it rock or cement? Is it rock or paved?
Driveway is gravel. The trail is rock dust.
I think they would mess it up.
Well, I think on a trail, definitely not. It's a walking trail. Agreed?
Yeah, yes. Because you got people walking. Yes. They don't want bicycles and stuff like that. They're walking.
Okay. Yeah. What about as far as on the drive or in the park other than that?
The drive.
I don't see anything wrong with a bicycle. Would that mess anything up?
I don't know.
I mean, where are they going to ride it if they're not riding it on the on the walking trail?
Well, there's right, that gravel the loop that goes around the gravel
driveway.
Goes around.
Yeah.
The driveway.
I don't want to be walking on the track with bicycles myself. I mean, the track's for walking.
Okay, so the track, definitely no. What about as far as within the park and the driveway area with bicycles.
I don't think it's a good idea, but
I don't either.
Well, I agree with bicycles, but like a tricycle. Somebody wanted to bring their kid's tricycle up there with them and walk next to them while they're doing the tricycle on the driveway. I don't see that damaging anything.
Yeah, maybe the tricycle because the kids are smaller, but when you get bigger kids and bikes and stuff, that
asking for it.
Because kids 11, 12, 13 might come and they have no parents with them.
I agree, but I think a tricycle, sometimes they're 2 or 3 year old and wants to let them ride their tricycle around the loop while their older kids are playing on the playground. Nothing wrong with that.
Okay. One of the things that they included in Walkertown, then it sounds like you would also go with, is no skateboards, rollerblades, or roller skates allowed in the park.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Okay. One of the other restrictions they have is motorized vehicles are restricted to parking lots and roadways, gas-powered remote control, and battery-powered hobby cars, planes, and vehicles are prohibited from the park.
Yeah, I just see the park as a family get-together to walk and not bring all your gadgets with you, really. I don't know.
Are you talking about like model airplanes that people?
Yes.
Fly? Okay.
Drones.
Okay. Yeah, that sounds fine.
Okay. They also included in theirs, camping is prohibited. Tents may not be erected at the park. Fires may only be built in grill enclosures provided at the park.
Yeah.
Okay. For substances.
George.
Yes.
Could you make us a list of that?
Sure.
Of the things you've mentioned? And I'd like to make a motion we table this until the November meeting.
Okay.
Yeah, I'd like some time to look at some of this stuff too and think about it, maybe talk to people and see what their people out in the community and see what their thoughts are.
One thing that I would like some guidance on.
Okay.
With the park, we're talking about it being open to the general public. It has the shelter. It has the restrooms. It has the stage, the amphitheater area. It has the walking trail. It has the playground equipment, etc. That during the day that it's simply open to just the general public using the park. But now you also mentioned just a short while ago about people renting stuff. For instance, on weekends, would we want the shelter or the stage for rental purposes?
I think we should. And I think we should maybe keep a record on reservations.
Mm-hmm. Be an application process for that as well, then.
Correct.
Okay. And I know that in talking with some of the other municipalities, one of the things that they suggested is that if you do a rental event, that there be a deposit that's paid because we want to keep the park clean and we want to keep it in good repair. That's something to think of as well. Are there any other areas of concern that you have or visions that you have that these guidelines, regulations, rules should cover?
Now, are we talking about a rental fee on the picnic shelter?
Probably. I could see, I'll use this as an example. My wife is and I are part of the Puckett family. We get together for event, or at least we did before COVID. For events. One of the events that we would do, for instance, is a stew planting event. Or another we would do, we get together everybody at Thanksgiving and do a pig picking. I could see where doing that outdoors at the shelter would be, and it would normally be on a weekend. To me, that's a scheduled event, and that's probably a rental fee. But just during the week when people are visiting the park and they're there with their kids and they're taking advantage of a place to eat their lunch or watch their kids play on the playground or sit on the bench and enjoy the trees, or it's just open to the public. But there are probably going, with the stage in particular, there are going to be times when people want to use it for performances. That's going to mean evening. That's going to mean staffing. That's going to mean, you know, some things where we're going to have to think in terms of having things that may not be town scheduled events. Therefore, there probably should be some rental fee involved.
Well, that's what I was thinking. If anything, for scheduled events like that, we might need, you know, a rental fee to cover someone coming in and making sure that things get cleaned up and checking behind, that sort of thing. If it's a, you know, if it's a something with the stage, you know, we've got, you know, we'll definitely want somebody there. Now, I do think there will be things. I want the stage to be available, you know, for in-kind things for the community. So if we have nonprofit organizations and whatnot that, that, you know, need to or want to use our stage for a fundraiser or something along those lines, I'd like us to work with them as much as we can, and not make it cumbersome. But, you know, there are going to be things that we know we're going to have a staff person available for.
So. Yvonne's also looking forward to covering those too.
Also, you would need to figure out how you're going to let people know, the people that just want to come to the park, that the shelter's not available if it's rented.
Yeah, that's what I was thinking about.
Or something like that. I mean, a way to do that.
Well, and then there's going to be a need for some signage, for instance, too. Like, for instance, we are going to have cameras in the park, and we want people to know they're under surveillance while they're in there, so that the cameras are there for surveillance purposes. And also, I've already talked with North Carolina Wildlife folks about including some signage about the type of wildlife that is in and around there. When I've been walking on the trail, there have been lots of deer tracks, moles, turkey tracks and feathers. One day I went out there and there was a nice 5-foot-long black snake out there as well. People need to understand that it's a trail that's going in the woods and there's nature there. And the wildlife, North Carolina wildlife folks said they were doing something similar for that in Eden at Freedom Park, and that they would look into doing something like that for us here as well.
Okay.
All right.
George, if you would make us a list of what we have discussed.
Add some suggestions as well.
Yeah.
Right. And I'd like to make a motion to table this until the next meeting.
A second. Because I think it needs to be a little more discussion.
Maybe you could email all of us or whatever.
I was going to say, you could send that out ahead of the packet so we have a little more time to look at it and go through it and think about it.
Let us review it. Mm-hmm. Have a motion and a second. Yvonne, would you do a roll call vote?
Please state your vote by saying aye or nay. Cheryl Moore?
Aye.
Iris Powell?
Aye.
Evelyn Connor?
Aye.
Dennis Pascal?
Aye.
All voted in favor.
Next is the discussion of memorial plaques for the park benches.
Ron, you want to take point on this one?
We had one person contact the mayor about having a memorial plaque on one of the benches for his grandparents. And when I talked to the mayor, you know, he mentioned we have limited number of park benches, so he's not sure how much we want to get into that, but he thinks that we do need to possibly do something for Wayne Hall and Clarence Cheshire, since family members have already given us memorial money for them in the past, and that's something that we could use it on. But when I talked to him earlier today, he had, you know, hoped that we could table it until the next meeting.
Okay.
Well, I like, wasn't able to attend tonight.
Well, and that's something I think we need to look out for, add to that discussion list too, because there's several ways you could do that. You know, you could, we could put pavers down in like an area, as you know, if people wanted to add that, if there was some use for it, if we needed to have brick pavers or something put down and people wanted to do that, we could always do a campaign like that. But I think that's something worth, you know, letting us take some time to think about and look at.
Plantings might also be something you're interested in too.
Do what?
What was that, George?
Doing some form of plantings, trees, you know, or bushes or something along, you know, along those flowers. I mean, there's, it's like I say, it's 7.4 acres and most of the trees, we left some for shade, but we might want to consider looking at that as well.
Okay.
We got to make it pretty. Got to have some flowers.
Mm-hmm. Well, I'd like to make a motion that we table this also until the November 3rd meeting.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Yvonne, would you do a roll call vote?
Please state your vote, aye or nay. Cheryl Moore?
Aye.
Iris Powell?
Aye.
Evelyn Connor?
Aye.
Dennis Paschal?
Aye.
All voted in favor.
Next is public comments. Yvonne, did we receive any?
Evelyn, sorry to interrupt you. Can I jump? Was there not anything about the Strata Solar Farm on the agenda for tonight?
No.
About the what?
The Strata Solar Farm for a lease extension?
No. I haven't been made aware of anything about it. Have you, George?
Okay. Cool. I was talking with Tom and Dennis. I thought that was on the agenda for tonight, but if it wasn't, it was fine. Sorry. Continue. I didn't mean to interrupt.
That's okay.
Yeah, no problem. Let me check email one last time. We had not had any before the meeting started. Okay, no, still no meetings for public comments. I mean, sorry, no emails for public comments.
Okay. Next, we'll move on to announcements. The next regular meeting of the Wentworth Planning Board is scheduled for Tuesday, October the 20th, 2020 at 7 o'clock p.m. and will be held electronically via a Zoom. Instructions on how to view the meeting will be posted on the town's website and Facebook page. The next regular meeting of the Wentworth Town Council is scheduled for Tuesday, November the 3rd, 2020 at 7 o'clock p.m. and will be held electronically via Zoom. And instructions on how to view the meeting will be posted on the town's website and Facebook page. Daylight savings time begins Sunday, November the 1st, 2020, and we will fall back. Election day is November the 3rd, 2020. For voting information, call the Rockingham County Board of Elections at 336-342-8107. Any other comments or business?
Does early voting in North Carolina begin October 15th? Am I correct?
Correct.
Through the 31st.
Okay. Correct.
I'm sure people need that.
Well, if there are no more comments or business, I'd like to make a motion that we adjourn.
Second.
Have a motion and a second. Yvonne, do we need to do a roll call on that?
You don't have to.
Okay. Meeting adjourned.